knocking on doors, talking to people about the Public Safety Training Center, getting their perspective on it, and we're trying to, you know, make this better for your community, but also for the overall region.
Hey, we're feeling good. Good.
Enjoy the rest of your Sunday.
It is really meaningful to the community to have the mayor come out and to have the police chief come out, because I think it gives people an opportunity to ask the questions that they may have otherwise felt like they didn't have a direct connection to the city on answers for.
Yeah, we need that over there, man, because, you know, I mean, it's hard for the other people over this way.
I think there's been a lot of misinformation about what the Atlanta Public Safety Training Center is going to be.
They're going to have people coming, you know, from other states and training in this place, and I'm like, well, I don't really know what to say.
Hearing negative sound bites and seeing negative clips.
The narrative that they're spreading is really trying to scare people off.
The training tactics that already exist are the training tactics that will be used at this facility.
But I really hadn't heard anything positive until today about what it really will mean for the training of both the fire and the police.
We did ask for safety. We did ask for security, and I think it's very important that we're very true to that. We're talking about protection and preserving the sanctity of not only community, neighborhood, and family, and that means a lot to me.
Police need to be trained. They need to be trained properly. 21st century policing is important, and training and morale is important. So I believe, and definitely, you know, the mission is to get proper training for the police.
Police have to be prepared. When agencies have to come together and work together, it need not be the very first time that they've experienced such a circumstance.
The Police Academy doesn't necessarily benefit us at DeKalb. I feel like it does benefit me because, you know, like I said, 99% of what I do is in the city of Atlanta.
Living here, right, the noise thing, right, has been an issue for us a long time.
It's definitely a concern of mine, and the explosives are definitely a big issue.
Citizen input matters. The last input y'all gave said move the firing range somewhere else. So the firing range is going to move a half mile away from here, and it's going to have a baffle over it, which should reduce the noise significantly where you won't hear that. That's what you asked for, and that's what you're going to get.
I'll be upfront. I'm not a fan of the training center. That's one of the four lungs of Metro Atlanta as it pertains to the tree coverage and the oxygen that it provides.
And let me say that I'm glad you felt comfortable enough to share that with me to my face versus Twitter fingers and craziness. I can't just tweet you that they're gonna tear down a forest and you believe it. I gotta show you the pictures of what is there and what will be changed. No, it doesn't seem like a new construction of a safety training center provides opportunity for you. But think about it this way. We're not disturbing the lungs of the city. We're actually trying to make the lungs be utilized versus be dumped on. So what we're doing is we're saying, let's activate it. Let's make it useful. Let's make it beautiful. We're actually going to allow you to have a trail through the forest. But the 85 acres, which is the site that has been clear cut over and over again, there's only four hardwood trees there. If we take down one, we have to replace it with 100.
Even though I'm in DeKalb, the benefits that I'll have from the green space and the park, that was a relief.
I really implore people to go to atltrainingcenter.com and look at the information that's out there. If they learn a little bit more about what the training center will actually be, you have to have an appropriate training site for fire, for police, for E911, if you ultimately want to have a better community.